thanks for checking out my channel. I'm going to look at natural gas for the week, the coming week, and what we could expect from here. So similarly to the move we had back here in that was November day, we had that very range, long range, that was actually moving to the upside. We had in the same time trend line, we had that divergence only 4 hours, and now we are having pretty much the same situation here with that move to the upside that's actually losing momentum as we go. We have large red candles that actually signaling that the sellers are here, but buyers are still protecting that level for now. Did almost close the gap at 260, and now we are basically reaching a trend line here with the third test. So are we going to break higher? The momentum is actually not telling us that will be the case, but of course that can still happen. There's a bit of room to move higher. I believe we are going to potentially test 275. Is it going to happen on Monday? It's hard to tell. The weather is a little bit mixed, but it's gonna get some cold next week around Christmas, but also some really warm weather on the east coast before that, cold front following. It's really a lot of uncertainty here. So but the longer term for this winter is not actually calling for major cold, so to break the 280 it will be difficult, I believe, at the moment, and more likely I think we're going to drop from a potential move to the upside here, some sort of a false break of the trend line before we actually resume to the downside. So are we going to break the 240? That's the question. The chart is telling us it is very much possible to drop that low, mainly because we're having still that very large divergence that's pointing to that opening gap at 280 to fill. The gap is still open here, the trend line is running there, so 210, it's almost now probably 215 more likely, is definitely calling for as an end for that swing, should we actually break that level. So looking at the quote report for a period that was relatively bullish from 245 up to 266, and we can see it was dropping open interest, so it's not really supporting that move. We could also see that the image money did actually mainly did some short covering during that time, but didn't increase their long position, that actually reduced it as well. Could see pretty much everywhere was quite neutral. Other funds did actually stay rather neutral, reducing long and short. Same for the retail traders, so there's really not much of a bullish case here. We can see the swap dealers were edging for lower price by increasing their long exposure. So overall I believe that's rather bearish in terms of the quote report, as not actually accumulating for a major break to the upside. So yeah, that will be the plan. Should we actually break that 278 to 80 convincingly and take of course higher, will be probably best to exit any short position, not to stay exposed to potential move higher. I doubt it will be the case. I don't see really what could be the catalyst for this, but of course in trading everything is possible, so just to be careful we need to sit and keep that stop loss there, limit the losses on that trade. And I'm still waiting for the reaction at 275 to load the last short or to decide if exiting the position with a small loss. So yeah, that's all about natural gas. I'll check that midweek on the Wednesday night, should be interesting ahead of the cold front coming, and see where the price is. Could get a buy opportunity to trade to the upside, should we drop to 240, so we'll see that then. But yeah, wish you safe trading, trade safe of course with natural gas as always, and I speak to you soon. Cheers, bye.